From the mysterious tropical rainforest to the deep ocean, from the towering Mount Wuzhishan to the vast wetland, nature has endowed Hainan with precious ecological treasure. Early in the morning, in Baowangling Forest, west of Hainan, the melodious cries of Hainan gibbons awakened the rainforest to a new day. Hainan gibbons are under national first-class protection. With less than 100 of them in total, they're the most endangered primate on Earth. And Baowangling is their sole habitat. From 2012 to 2022, in the span of a decade, researchers have been working on Baowangling with the gibbons. The mountains where the gibbons inhabit boast more than 5,000 acres of gibbons' favorite plants. In January 2022, these gibbons welcomed a new cub, meaning a rise in population from 10 of 2 bands to 36 of 5 bands. Baowangling, the gibbons' habitat, is the core of Hainan National Tropical Rainforest Park. The main body of the park is located in the central mountainous areas of Hainan Island. With a total area of more than 4,400 square kilometers, about 1/7 of the land on the island. In the light of holistic management, Hainan proposed the blueprint of holistic zoning. The current red line for ecological protection covers 33.5% of the land area, 35.1% of the offshore coastal waters. A province-wide ecological security barrier has been erected. The red line for ecological and environmental protection is strictly followed. Limitations on utilization of resources are adhered to. The top-level design for the National Ecological Pilot Zone is made to initiate reconstructuring of the local government bodies and spur solid steps in the institutional improvement. The roadmap for the National Ecological Pilot Zone is clearer. Strictest eco-protection institution has been applied. In Hainan, 2/3 of cities and countries are exempt from GDP assessment. 3 red lines and 1 negative list is applied for regional specific eco-management. A basin-wide compensation mechanism is in the making. For 10 years, Hainan has been working hard on preserving its blue sky, clear water and clean environment. At the end of 2021, Hainan issued the Cleanup and Remediation Plan for small hydropower stations in Hainan Province based on the principle of putting eco-protection first. Small hydropower stations in the National Rainforest Park were shut down one by one. Among them, the Baowangling area of Changqiang River was the first. In 2019, Hainan issued the Ecological Relocation Plan of Hainan National Tropical Rainforest Park. Ecological relocation benefits both people and the nature. However, local residents are worried about where to live and how to sustain their life. For the locals to better understand the policy, Wuzhishan City set up a special work team on relocation to explain the policy to the residents and dispel their worries. After the relocation, resettlement measures were introduced to assign the residents to public welfare posts, such as rangers, janitors, and drivers. Job-specific training was also offered to dispel the villagers' concerns about future life, so that they could settle down and stay at ease. In order to protect this vast rainforest, 470 households will relocate elsewhere. and return the living space to the rainforest. In so doing, they'll also become the guards and builders of the tropical rainforest. The past decade also saw Hainan's great strides towards the new energy vehicle era. Efforts have been made in improving charging facilities, building convenient urban-rural power grid, weaving an island-wide gas network, and advancing major energy projects such as Changqiang Nuclear Power Phase 2 and Changqiang Small Reactor Demonstration Project. Clean Energy Island, a landmark project in Hainan Ecological Pilot Zone, is in full swing. Hainan is the first province in China to have committed to banning sales of fuel-powered vehicles by 2030. Its ratio of existing and newly added clean energy vehicles is significantly higher than the national average. This is China's first homegrown and world-leading plastic banning equipment developed by Hainan on December 1st, 2020. To bolster the construction of the ecological pilot zone, Hainan brought its holistic plastic ban to a new level. A research team from Hainan ran a lot of tests and finally developed this intelligent plastic detector. As of August 2022, Hainan has handled more than 1,700 cases on plastic ban, closed more than 1,300 cases, and seized over 1,500 million prohibited plastic products. In addition to the ban on plastics, in 2020, the Hainan government listed prefabricated buildings among the four landmark projects in the National Ecological Pilot Zone. Prefabricated buildings represent an important move to transform and upgrade the construction industry and to support Hainan's endeavors for contributing to China's 30-60 goals. Following the 2017 move to promote prefabricated buildings, the area of such buildings soared from 0.82 million in 2018 to 22.8 million square meters in 2021, with an annual twofold rise for four consecutive years. It also plays a crucial role in reconstructing in construction industry, urban and rural development, and green development. From rainforest protection to the overall plastic ban, and then to the promotion of prefabricated buildings, the Hainan National Ecological Pilot Zone has been warmly welcomed and well received. Ten years on, Hainan's ecological environment is improving constantly. Its ecological quality has been leading in the country. Concentration of PM2.5 dropped from 25 microgram per cubic meters 10 years ago to 13 microgram per cubic meters today. Air quality is good on 99% days. Centralized treatment rate of urban domestic sewage increased from 75% to 99.6%. The use of pesticides and fertilizers dropped significantly. Meanwhile, Hainan strictly applied corrective measures based on feedback from central environmental inspectors and national marine inspectors and rolled out treatment in six key aspects and along the coastline. As of January 1st, 2021, 16 domestic garbage landfills in Hainan were shut down, making it China's first province with zero landfill for domestic garbage. In 10 years, a total of 9 mangrove-based nature reserves were established. There are 3 mangrove wetland parks, and wetland biodiversity is increasingly higher. This is what a local enterprise in Hainan has developed for sewage treatment, the RCERP technology. At the end of 2021, in order to further promote the Hainan National Ecological Pilot Zone, the overall water treatment project was launched to make breakthroughs via holistic management of water environment. Systemic measures have been rolled out to treat sewage, secure water supply, drain floods, control floods, save water, and clarify seawater. To that end, scientists and technicians in Hainan are doing their part by using the photosynthesis and allelopathy of plants to treat sewage and form an efficient and self-purifying ecosystem. Wensan Wetland Park, located in Tuangcheng Town, Tuangcheng, and once afflicted by urban and rural domestic sewage and agricultural pollution, and its water quality tested inferior V. Thanks to the RCERP technology, the ecosystem of Wensan water system was recovered and the water quality tested grade A again. In 2022, to further intensify the National Ecological Pilot Zone, the Hainan Provincial Government proposed to strive to be the top student in the 3060 program, build a zero-carbon Dongyu Island, set up the International Blue Carbon Research Center, carry out in-depth and frontier academic studies, and step up international cooperation. 10 years on, what Hainan has achieved inspires people to preserve the green mountains and lucid waters for sustaining wealth and prosperity. Hainan will stick to its journey of ecological conservation and strive to realize the dream of making Hainan the evergreen garden of China.